Welcome to all of you on this beautiful day. Let us begin our announcement of this event with prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Gracious God, eternal shepherd, you tend your church in many ways and rule us with love. You have nourished and protected your church by providing it with pastors who are stewards of your word and sacraments. Today we give you thanks for your chosen servant, Michael, to be our pastor for Christ, to watch over your flock as our next bishop. Watch over him, Lord, and guide him as he begins his holy ministry. Let him know the prayerful support of your people by governing with fidelity those entrusted to his care. May he build your church here in North Texas as a sign of salvation for all the world. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
So we gather here this morning joyfully to celebrate this announcement, which was made earlier this morning by the Apostolic Nuncio, that the Holy Father, Pope Francis, has selected the Reverend Monsignor Michael Olson as the fourth bishop of the Catholic Diocese of Fort Worth. Bishop-elect Olson is a priest of the Diocese of Fort Worth and is returning back to us from his current assignment as rector of Holy Trinity Seminary in Irving. So on behalf of the 700,000 Catholics, the 89 parishes, and all of the faithful in North Texas, and with gratitude to God and to Pope Francis, I present to you now our bishop-elect, Michael Olson.
Thank you, Monsignor Berg, and thank you all very much for being here this morning. I know over the last, going on 14 months, we've all been praying for a new bishop, and last Tuesday morning, I received a phone call from the Apostolic Nuncio. Actually, first I received a voicemail message from him, and then waited a while and then called after some prayers, and then the Nuncio, Archbishop Vigano, very graciously informed me that our Holy Father, Pope Francis, had asked me to be the next Bishop of Fort Worth. And I responded to him at the time, as I respond today, relying on the help of Almighty God and with the help of His Blessed Mother, I accept. And so the last week has really been a week of discernment and prayer. Prayer for all of you, as well as prayer for me, and prayer especially for our priests, our deacons, our religious, and our staff here at the Catholic Center. I'm very humbled by Pope Francis's trust for me in what the Nuncio articulated to me is that the Holy Father holds this diocese, our diocese, in great esteem, as part of the new evangelization and as part of a vital area of growth in the church, in the church in the United States. And so I told the Nuncio that I would convey that to all of you on this day. So I, with that, first of all, I just, gratitude is in order. First of all, gratitude to the Holy Father for this assignment, this mission. Gratitude to my parents for the gift of life, the gift of my faith. Gratitude also for the gift of my priesthood for the last 20 years, going on 20 years. Gratitude to Holy Trinity Seminary, where I've been assigned for the last 5.5 years, to all the seminarians who are there and who are watching this on live stream and who should be studying and stuff. I offer them my thanks as well as my faculty and staff. Gratitude to all of you for your prayers. I thought, just as part of the statement, I thought that really is our first act together as a diocese after this statement and questions, it would be important for us to pray together. And so I've scheduled myself for the noon mass at the cathedral at St. Patrick's, and all of you are very much invited to attend so that we can pray together at the Eucharist, which is the most important thing we can do on earth. I told Monsignor Pemberton he can keep the stipend, but I did want to take the mass. So anyway, with that, I just would throw it open to questions.
Monsignor, what do you see as the greatest challenges the diocese faces moving forward?
Well, I'll repeat the questions for the sake of the media. If I get the question wrong, please ask it again, and I'll repeat it, and then I'll answer the question I wish you had asked. So, what are the challenges facing the diocese? Well, in some ways, I think they're the same challenges that we always face, but with a renewed emphasis, especially on evangelization, we live our faith, that the church provides the ordinary means by which we encounter Christ, by which we grow in our faith, and we come together as the church. And then all the rest are sort of, the devil, of course, is in the details with that. And I think, as I was thinking about this week, I obviously it's too early to give a plan or a program, but I think if there's a horizon I see out there, I would say the main point is evangelization, the spread of the gospel. And then those would be three subsets would be under there. First of all, formation and discipleship, which involves the formation in the sacramental life, education in the faith, ministry to the poor, especially and to those who would fall through the margins of society, and that includes the immigrant, it includes the unborn, it includes so many people affected by poverty without access to health care, all sorts of things. Those people who would otherwise fall through the margins of society, who don't have a voice. And then thirdly, and anchored in discipleship, is vocations. Priestly vocations, religious vocations, diaconal vocations, you know, vocations just based in our baptism. All of those, to hear the call, to answer it, and to put it into action through ministry. That, I think, is overview. Other questions? Father?
I hope I don't put you on the spot. Will you be able to join us on Sunday for as we plan for the closure of the Year of Faith?
Let me repeat the question. Will I be able to join you on Sunday?
As planned.
Oh, yes. Okay, let me ask the question again here. I feel the translator here. All right. Will I be able to join you as planned on Sunday for the end of the year of the close of the Year of Faith? Yes, I will, as planned.
Thank you.
And I will concelebrate with my classmate, Bishop Oscar Cantu, who's coming to look forward to that. And so I look forward to welcoming him and also to concelebrating with him to hear what he has to say as well. So I can, like the old seminary days, maybe copy off his paper beforehand. Anyway, so general confession. Okay. Other questions?
Being a Chicago area native,
yes.
Cubs or Sox?
a malignant question from the press. The question was, being a native of Chicago, Cubs or Sox? I am a White Sox fan, all right? And lifelong White Sox fan, and not a Cub fan at all. I root for the White Sox and whoever plays the Cubs. And then the Rangers now have replaced whoever plays the Cubs as number two. But number three is whoever plays the Cubs. So thank you, good question. It's an easy enough question. I've taken harder questions from the press in this room, and we have documented evidence of that in my time. So, other questions? Okay, well, that's very easy. We move on. I guess just a general statement is I love being a priest. All right. I have loved being a priest since my ordination, and I've loved it very much, more and more. I've had many ministries in my priesthood, but every one of them, whether it was rector of the seminary or vicar general or pastor or associate pastor or even doctoral student, I've always done as a priest. And I sort of understand myself in those terms. Even I suspect now, as Providence has afforded me this opportunity and this new ministry, I'm consoled by the fact that being a bishop means experiencing the fullness of priesthood. And that's a great consolation to me, because then it renews the way I can do this ministry for the good of all. I've looked very much for an actual citation of this, but I do remember reading it, a quote from John the 23rd, and that is, you know, he took this from his bishop and mentor, Archbishop Radini Tedeschi, who said that he prefers to think of a bishop being given to a diocese instead of a bishop being given a diocese. And I've always sort of approached every priestly assignment I've had, at least on my good days, that way. And I intend to approach this assignment as well, that in a sense, I'm being given to you in this new way, and especially in a very special way to the priests, and then also to the deacons and religious, because they're my most proximate concern. I mean, I'm concerned for all of you, you know, and will be even more as time goes on after ordination, but most especially, the care of the soul of priests is very important and essential and necessary for this ministry. And I say that right now. So thank you. Any other questions at all? Okay. Well, thank you, then.
Do we need Spanish? Anybody want Spanish? Media? I don't think so. No.
All right, well, why don't I make a, should I, is
just make a quick statement.
Sí, voy a hacer una declaración breve en español en este caso. Hace una semana yo recibí una llamada telefónica del anuncio apostólico al obispo Vigano, el representante de su santidad, Papa Francisco. Y él me dijo que yo soy el nuevo obispo de la diócesis de Fort Worth. Yo pido a su paciencia porque el español es mi segundo idioma, pero yo puedo entender más que lo puedo hablar con gran dicción, ortografía también. Pero yo pido de sus oraciones, todas sus oraciones, para mí y para la diócesis también, porque nosotros formamos solamente una iglesia aquí, una iglesia con dos lenguas o muchas lenguas, y también una iglesia con muchas culturas, y necesitamos tener paciencia entre nosotros. Yo también tengo... En mi mente y en mi corazón, yo tengo a los jóvenes hispanos, especialmente ellos que hablan español en sus hogares con sus padres, pero necesitan hablar inglés en la escuela, y ellos necesitan vivir en dos culturas distintas y a veces varias culturas adversarios. Y es más importante y imperativo por nosotros predicar y vivir el Evangelio con ellos para prepararles en el futuro por la iglesia, en el futuro y también en el presente. So, muchas gracias. I hope to see you all at Mass then at noon, so to pray together. Thank you very much.